Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Kat, and today I'm going to be talking about six of my most highly anticipated books for September. Now, it was hard to narrow it down, but I didn't want to put too many books in this video because I am just really excited to talk about my most anticipated. So, a lot of them are dark, a lot of them are creepy, and then we have one really, really cute, sweet one. So let's go ahead and get right on into it, and this is going to be by release date, so from early September to late September. So the first one that I want to talk about is The Memory Police by Yoko Ogawa, out the 8th. The Memory Police follows a woman who is a writer, and she lives on a very remote island where when things go missing, they are erased from the memory of the populace. And the memory police go around the island and remove those objects which people have forgotten about. Except there are some people who can remember. So the main character realizes that her editor is actually in danger of the memory police because he is one of those people that remembers. So she decides to hide him away and try to get to the bottom of the disappearances and the remembering and what's really happening on the island. So I'm really keen to get to this. I have been talking about it all year, so you're probably sick of hearing me talk about it. So, okay, let's move on to the next one. So out September 10th is Gideon the 9th by Tamsyn Muir. And this one we are following an undead reanimated corpse named Gideon. So Gideon is kind of a warrior, but also lazy and can't be bothered. And when the king of the courts, I believe, has a tournament to grant immortality or like power to the different devils, ghouls, and reanimated corpses, Gideon is forced to join as part of the fealty he owes to the lord of his area, I believe. There's like one line that got me, and it's like, she packs up her sword, her books, her shoes, her dirty magazines, and prepares to launch her daring escape. But her childhood nemesis won't let her free without a service. So it's kind of very tongue-in-cheek, and I believe that it has like necromancy and battles to the death and like an undead main lesbian character, I think. So I'm here for it. Also at the 10th is a book that I don't really need to explain. It's The Testaments by Margaret Atwood. So yeah, unless you've been living under a rock, you know that this is the follow-up sequel to Handmaid's Tale. And I must say that I probably wouldn't have been that excited for it if it had just been just the book, but because I am an avid lover of the TV show, it has made the hype so real. So the next book that I want to talk about comes out the 17th, and it is The Tea Dragon Festival by Katie O'Neill. Now, if you have watched any of my wrap-ups, then you probably know that I'm a huge Katie O'Neill fan. I love everything that she makes. This follows the same world as The Tea Dragon Society, except we are following a little girl named Rin, who grows up in the same town as the tea dragons when she stumbles upon a real life big dragon whose name is Aiden. And Aiden has been put to sleep and has been sleeping for hundreds and hundreds of years when he was supposed to be protecting the village, and he doesn't know why. So she, along with the owners of the tea dragon tea house, set off to uncover the mystery of his enchanted sleep. I think it sounds adorable, it has a lot of queer rep, it's beautifully illustrated, and it's perfect for any age reader, and I cannot wait to read it. The fifth book that I want to talk about is The Bone Houses by Emily Lloyd-Jones. This is out the 24th. Now this one is another great read for Halloween, along with Gideon the 9th. And we are following 17-year-old Rin, who is a grave digger. Now, grave diggers in this world are not the grave diggers that we know, because the graveyard that the family tends borders the Fey lands, and not all of the dead stay dead. When the dead rise, they are called bone houses, and her family has to deal with these bone houses, and for some reason, more and more of them are awakening out of the earth. Then an apprentice map maker comes to town named Ellis, and the bone houses start rising ever more. And so they are trying to figure out why the bone houses are attracted to Ellis and what they can do to stop this, like, basically onslaught of undead. So I think it just sounds awesome. I'm really excited about it. It's shelved as fantasy, young adult, and horror, which is a perfect blend in my opinion. Yeah, so I'm really keen to get to it, and it's going absolutely straight onto my Halloween TBR. And the sixth book that I want to talk about today is The Future of Another Timeline by Annalee Newitz. Now, this is the same author who wrote Autonomous, and Autonomous was like a problematic fave. So many of the elements I couldn't stop thinking about and I thought were highly original, yet there were also, to be fair, some very problematic elements within this book, but the originality and the writing style was so unique that I immediately wanted to read anything else by Annalee Newitz. So in this one, we are following two different timelines. One is 1992, when 17-year-old Beth finds herself in a car with, I believe, a dead man's body. And then we are following the other timeline, which is 2022, where she has decided to go back into the past to fix key moments and change history. So it sounds interesting. Honestly, if this had been by any author, I don't think I would have picked it up, but because it is by Annalee Newitz, I think that I am really intrigued and really excited to see what she does with it, and I just cannot wait. So those are six books that I'm really, really highly anticipating for September. Two of them are going to go immediately onto my October TBR, Gideon the Ninth and The Bone Houses. Also, a shout out to The Babysitters Coven, I believe. I'm not sure when it came out or when it's coming out, but it's also coming out in September. But I'm really just not such a huge fan of The Babysitters Club in general, so I wasn't going to mention it, but I figured I would if you're trying to build up your October spooky TBR. So yeah, I hope that you like this video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up or hit the subscribe button. That would be amazing. The sun is shining today and I'm so, so happy about that. So I'm gonna go and bike down the coast to do some op shop, which is opportunity shop, which is thrift shop to people not in Australia, shopping, as well as a used bookstore, as well as going to do some work at a library, a new library that I've never been to before. So I'm so excited. I'm having an awesome day. I hope that you guys are too. And without further ado, I'm gonna say bye till my next video. Bye.